إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله سبحان الله ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد سبحان الله When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Muhajireen, who are the Muhajireen? The Muhajireen are those companions that left Mecca and migrated to Medina. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Muhajireen, when they left Mecca to go to Medina, the people of Medina, they welcomed them with an open arms. They were happy to receive them. They loved them. And Allah gave the people of Medina the title of Al-Ansar. Al-Ansar is the helpers because they fulfill the requirement of brotherhood in Islam. You want brotherhood in Islam? Go study the life of the Ansar. How they were when the Muhajirin came to them. They opened their arms. They were willing to share everything with the Muhajirin for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. You and I can learn from the way they practice, from the way they dealt with their brothers, with the Muhajirin. They left their home in Mecca and come to Medina. They didn't have any bad feelings towards them. They loved them. They were happy. SubhanAllah, this is a beautiful example, a beautiful story that happened between one of the Muhajireen and one of the Ansar. SubhanAllah, the Prophet ﷺ told them to pair up. The Muhajireen, his name was Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. And the Ansar, his name, the Ansari, his name was Sa'd ibn al-Rabi'a. SubhanAllah, Sa'd, he came to the Muhajir, Abdul Rahman. He says, I am one of the wealthiest in Medina. Welcome. I am one of the wealthiest in Medina. I have two gardens. Look at this. Look at the selflessness. He said, I have two gardens and I have two wives. You have nothing. I want you to go into my two gardens. Pick whichever you want. Pick the one you want and I'll give it to you. I will give it to you for the sake of Allah. And look at my wives, the one that is pleasing to you. I will divorce her. And when her waiting period is done, you can marry her. Allahu Akbar. This was the level of brotherhood the Ansar went to. They were willing to give everything for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. To the point that Allah Himself praises the Ansar in the Quran. Allah says about the Ansar, people of Medina, Allah said, يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ Allahu Akbar. Allah said the Ansar, they love the people that came to them. They actually have sincere love that Allah Himself affirmed the love that was in their heart. You and I today, when we do something good for each other, we go and talk behind someone's back. Oh, I gave him this, I gave him that. This guy was always begging me. This guy is always asking me. But look what Allah says about the Ansar. يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ They love those that came to them. وَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَّةً مِمَّا أُوذُوا Allahu Akbar. Allah said the Ansar, they didn't have any jealousy. They didn't have any hatred in their heart to what was given to the Muhajireen. They were happy to see them. Then Allah said, وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَى أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةً Allahu Akbar. Allah said the Muhajireen was so selfless. They were so willing to give everything to the Ansar. Allah said, they prefer the Muhajireen, the Ansar, they prefer the Muhajireen to get everything. Even though, وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا Even though they were in need of it. They themselves, not all of the Medina people were rich. Not all of them were rich, but they were willing to give to their brothers and sisters that left Mecca to come to Medina. They welcomed them with an open arm. In fact, the whole companions, Allah Azza wa Jal, praises the companion. Allah says, Muhammadu Rasulullah. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ أَشِدَّ وَلَى الْكُفَّارِ. Those that are with him, the companions, they are stern with the disbelievers. But guess what? Among themselves, رُحَمَّا بَيْنَهُمْ. The companions, they had mercy towards one another. They truly love each other for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Do we have that today? Let's really sit down. Do we really love our brothers and sisters for the sake of Allah? Allah, this brotherhood in Islam, we didn't make it up. I didn't make this up. Allah Himself said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. The believers are brothers. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. So Allah says, fix things between your brothers and sisters. When you see Muslims fighting among each other, Allah says, فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Fix things between them. Don't let two Muslims fight. Don't let Muslim groups hate each other. Allah said, fix things between them. I want to stop here for a second. Allah said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. This brotherhood is not based on wealth. It is not based on our skin color. It is not based, I'm from Pakistan, I'm from Africa, I'm from this nonsense. It's not based on that. It is not based on nationality. It is based on what? إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The believers, Iman is based on Iman. If you have, and then in the same surah, Allah mentioned, who are the believers? إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. Allahu Akbar. Allah, you want to know who the believers are? The believers are those that truly believe in Allah alone. They worship only Allah. And they believe that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the Prophet of Allah. ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. Then they have no doubt in this. They have no doubt that Islam is the true religion. They have no doubt. وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. Allah said, these believers, they strive with their lives and their wealth for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah said, these are the truthful ones. So these are the believers. Our brotherhood in Islam is based on our belief in the shahada that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah alone, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the prophet of Allah Azza wa Jal, and that Islam is a true religion. Anyone that comes with this belief, what do we do when someone accepts Islam? We say takbir, Allahu Akbar. We hug them, we kiss them, we give them everything. Because why? We are so happy to gain a brotherhood. This is what Islam is teaching you and I. To not have no bad feelings toward each other. Allah says, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضُ. Allahu Akbar. Allah says, they believe in men and they believe in women. They are what? They are supporters of one another. They are allies. We have each other's back. You can see a random Muslim walking and you see someone jump him. If you walk by that, something's wrong with your heart. If you see your fellow Muslims needing help and you don't care, because Allah said, we are what? Supporters of each other, friends of each other. Then Allah mentioned the things that we do together. Huh? وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْدُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. They enjoy good. We enjoy good, and the best of good that we enjoy is the tawheed of Allah, to worship Allah alone, and to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To be good to our parents, to be good to our neighbors, to pray 5 times a day, to pray zakat, to pay zakat, to fast in Ramadan. Ya'muruna bil ma'ruf. And the next one, Allah said, wa yanhauna 'anil munkar. And they forbid evil. The believers, everywhere they are, they strive to forbid evil. They strive to tell people to stay away from bad things. That Allah says, وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. The believers, what do they do? Allah said, they establish their 5 daily prayers. They pray 5 times a day together. Here we are right here, gathered together to pray for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's what we do. This is the common action that we do together. And that increases the love in our heart. That's why it's good that we come together in congregation to pray. We fast Ramadan together, we go to Hajj together, and we pay our zakat. Then Allah said, وَيُطِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. The believers, they obey Allah and His Messenger. Then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ, these people, أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ. These are the people Allah will have mercy upon. The believers that have each other's back, they pray 5 times a day, they make sure they enjoy good, they make sure they forbid evil action, they make sure they obey Allah and His Messenger. Allah said, these are the ones Allah will have mercy upon them, meaning Allah will forgive them and give them Jannah, inshaAllah. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet ﷺ says, لا يؤمن أحدكم None of you will believe. None of you shall have iman. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لنفسه حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet said, you will not have iman until you love for your brothers and sisters. And remember, every time we say brother, which is general, sisters is also included. You will not have iman until you love for your brothers and sisters what you love for yourself. Allahu Akbar. What a beautiful religion. Which religion teaches that? And Islam is the only religion that tells you that you have part of iman is to believe your fellow Muslims. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah, this religion teaches you and I to clean our heart from all hatred, all envy for those that believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla. We are supposed to love the believers of the past, of the present, of the future. Why? After Allah talks about the muhajirin, the companions in the Quran, when Allah talks about the companions, after he talks about them, Allah talks about those that comes after them. Those that will believe like them, those that will have the same action. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِ those that come after them, we, alhamdulillah, may Allah make us those that follow the way of the Salaf, the way of the Sahaba. Allah said, those that come after the Sahaba, يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا they say, oh Allah, forgive us. Oh Allah, forgive us. But is that it? Do they just say Allah forgive us and that's it? No. يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَ بِالْإِيمَانِ oh Allah, forgive us and forgive our brothers and sisters that accepted Islam in the past. Forgive us and forgive the Sahaba, the companion, the Salaf. We make dua for everyone. We make dua for ourselves and we make dua for each other. And guess what? The dua is not finishing. Allah said, what are we supposed to say? Oh Allah, وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلَّ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا wallahi, we should make this dua. Oh Allah, do not put any hatred in our heart. Oh Allah, do not put any negative feelings in our heart. Oh Allah, don't put any jealousy, any envy in our hearts for those that believe. Allahu Akbar. The people of Jannah, before they enter Jannah, Allah said what? وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ what's غِلٍّ? It's all the negative emotion, all the bad feelings you have towards people, jealousy, envy, all of that, we make dua to Allah to remove that. When you see your brothers and sisters, you are happy, you want to hug them, you love them, you miss them. This is what Islam is teaching us to do.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said a beautiful hadith, and we should all listen to this. This hadith is in Bukhari. Remember, Allah said that those who obey Allah and His Messenger. Now, let's listen what this Messenger is going to say to us. The Prophet said, لا تباغضوا. Don't hate each other. Don't have hatred for one another. ولا تحاسدوا. Don't have hasad. Don't have envy towards each other. What's envy? Envy is to be jealous of the things that Allah has given to your brothers and sisters. You see your brother, mashallah, she's doing good, he's doing good, and there's something in your heart, you hate that. You are jealous. You want them to not have that. Wallahi, this is evil. May Allah protect us from that. That's why we make that dua. Oh Allah, don't put that in our heart. So the Prophet said, don't have this towards your Muslim brothers. How can a believer have this towards their fellow believers? He said, وَلَا تَحَاسَدُوا وَلَا تَدَابَرُوا and don't turn away from each other. If you see a believing brother needing help, is struggling, help them if you are able to do that. Subhanallah. So how should we be? The Prophet SallAllahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا he said, be the servants of Allah as brothers. That's what we're supposed to be. And then he ends his hadith by saying, وَلَا يَحِلُّ لِمُسْلِمٍ أَنْ يَهْجُرَ أَخَاهُ فَوْقَ ثَلَاثٍ Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet said, it is not permissible for any Muslim, and Muslim is someone that believes that La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. If you believe in this, the Prophet said, it is not permissible for any Muslim to boycott, to not talk to his sister or brother, to stay away from his brother and sister for more than how many days? فَوْقَ ثَلَاثٍ for more than 3 days. You have 3 days to stay mad at your brothers and sisters. After 3 days, it's haram for you. If you see them, you don't say salam to them. Some of us, we don't talk to our brothers and sisters for months, years past.
We don't talk to them, and we come to the masjid praying 5 times a day, doing all that stuff. But there's something that's going on. We can't fix that. Subhanallah, the Prophet, it is not permissible. So right now, make sure you go home and you fix things between your brothers. If you have not talked to your brothers or sister, wallahi, you are disobeying the Prophet of Allah Azza wa Jal. And remember, وَمَا يُنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ, the Prophet didn't say anything from his desire. Everything he said, إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ, Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that told him. So the Prophet said, it's not permissible for you and I to stay away from our brothers and sisters for more than 3 days. Subhanallah. Islam teaches you and I a deep, a very intimate brotherhood. To the point that the Prophet said that the example of the love and the mercy, the kindness for the believers for each other. What's the example like? Listen to this example. The Prophet said the example of the believers for their love and their kindness towards each other is like a body, one body. What's that analogy? Look at this analogy. We all understand it. We all have body. He said if one part hurts, the whole body feels it. That's how we're supposed to be. That's why we cry when we hear about our brothers and sisters in Palestine suffering. That's why we are in pain when we hear people in Egypt suffering. When we hear our Muslims in Somalia, in other places, we cry for them, we make dua for them, because Islam is teaching us to have that in our heart. And guess what? It is part of Iman. The Prophet said, you will not have Iman until you love for your brother and sister what you love for yourself. Right now, you and I, alhamdulillah, we are in peace. So we should also pray for them to have peace. If we're not praying for them, there's something wrong with our Iman. Subhanallah, wallahi, there's so many ahadith I can talk about. But for the sake of time, let's call it short. Subhanallah, the Prophet said also that whoever relieves the hardship of his brother and sister in this dunya, meaning you know your brother is going through hardship, don't wait for him to come and tell you. Don't wait for the sister to come and tell you, oh, I'm going through hardship. If you know, the Prophet said, if you relieve them out of hardship, guess what? Allah will also do the same for you in this dunya and akhirah. The Prophet says, awesome, whoever make things easy for people in this dunya, Allah will also make things easy for you in this in the akhirah and in the dunya. Then he said, if you hide the faults of your Muslim sister and brothers, if you hide the sins, if you know someone is doing a sinful act, today we live in an evil culture. You see someone doing something haram, you put it on Facebook, you talk about it, you call your brothers and sisters, you email people about it. Wallahi, the Prophet said, if you hide someone's mistake, if you hide someone's sinful actions, then Allah will also hide your mistake in this dunya and in the akhirah. And I will end with this beautiful hadith. This hadith is so beautiful, one of my favorite hadith when it comes to encouraging people to love each other for the sake of Allah. On the day of judgment, the Prophet said, Inna Allaha yaqulu yawma al-qiyamah. Allah will say on the day of judgment, I want you to imagine this. Everybody is there on that day of judgment. From Adam all the way to the last human being, Allah will make an announcement. Allah will say, Aina al-mutahabuna bi jalali. Where are those that love each other for my sake? Imagine on this day. It is said, the Prophet said, that the sun will be brought close to us. It will be really hot. People will sweat on the day of judgment. Some people will sweat to the point, to their ankle, to their knee, to their waist, to their neck. Some people will drown in their sweat because of their sins. But on this day, there is no shade. There's no way you can run away. There's no trees. There's no house to find shelter. The only shelter, Allah said, أَيْنَ الْمُتَحَبُّونَ بِجَلَالِي أُذِلُّهُمْ فِي ذِلِّي. Allah Akbar. Allah said, where are those that love each other for my sake? Not for wealth. They only love each other for the sake of Allah. I love you because you pray 5 times a day. I love you because you believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. I love you because you follow the sunnah. That's why. That's the only reason. So Allah said, where are them? أُذِلُّهُمْ فِي ذِلِّي, so that I will cover them in my shade. And this shade Allah is talking about is under the throne of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah said, come, those that love each other for my sake, I will cover you. Al-yawma la dhilla illa dhilli. On the day of judgment, there is no shade except the shade Allah will cover you. Allah will give you under the stone. Allah Akbar. So this is the benefit to have love for each other. This is the benefit for us to strive. If we need to make dua for this. If you feel like your heart don't have this love for your believers, then ask Allah Azza wa Jalla. Just like in the Quran, وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Make that dua. Oh Allah, do not let any hatred, don't let any jealousy come in our heart for our fellow believers. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make you and I people that love each other for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. May Allah keep us firm and make us that as Muslims.